make sure that they're paying me for a valuable case. If it's not valuable, I'm going to be the first one to say, you don't want to file this case. You know, there are a lot of lawyers who will say, give me the money, I'll do my best, and we'll see what happens.
What is it about litigation that you love?
I don't know. I guess it's like maybe the competition, you know, the competition, the fight, the thrill of victory, you know, the agony of defeat. I mean, really, because there are times like when you lose, when I lose a case, I take it very personally. So, but you know, it's part of the process, but yeah, it's, I also love, this is going to sound so hokey. I really love our country and our constitution and that you're innocent until proven guilty. And I loved from the criminal perspective, from the prosecutor's perspective, I loved seeing how much went into a crime that was actually charged, being as ethical as being raised and brought up the way I was raised, and then even in the state attorney's office, living to that higher level.
Well, that's what
level.
I was just going to ask. What you learned in Reno's office about you had to be absolutely sure that the case was going to be winnable, in your mind at least. You brought that same philosophy, it sounds like, to the practice of elder law.
Right. I mean, it's a training. 3.5 years of that, I think it just indoctrinates you.
Right.
And yeah, I mean, because I can line up people who've wanted to hire me to file an action or even to defend an action. And my response could very well be, this is not an appropriate action to bring. You know, you need to mend fences, or even as a defense, let's settle. You did something wrong. Everyone does something wrong. You were sued. Let's not fight for the sake of fighting. Mm-hmm. Let's get the best settlement we can get and get you out and moving on with your life. Just, I like the fight, but I also like the checks and balances. In elder law, it's so different, because I say all the time, I'm not interested in the fight for the sake of the fight. So I think I put on more of that intake or due process or constitutional hat when I talk about elder law, when I analyze elder law cases, because in those cases and in my position, people are paying me to litigate.